Hey everyone, this is Marbles here, and this is part 4 of Let's Play XCOM Enemy Unknown Classic Ironman. So, I'm going to start from making some carapace armor. I need at least 4, which means I need more credits. Which means I need to sell some sectoid corpses. I don't really have any other choice. But I don't need them all that much. So I might as well do that. This should be good enough. Yeah, this will be good enough, I think. And I'm going to make 4 carapace armor. This should improve my survivability a little bit. I should have around 30 alloys left. Yeah, 30 alloys left. So I think that's it for now. I'm down to 6 credits anyway, so not much I can do for that. Satellite uplink is almost done. Oh, hi. Signature is a little bigger this time. Engaging bogey. One thing I'm not looking forward to is actually capturing live aliens. Come on, shoot it down. There we go. Alright, let's do this. I didn't name any new soldiers yet because I'm waiting for them to get the corporal rank. Alright, let me do this from zero. I need to bring at least one rookie here. Oh yeah, speaking of which, I need to hire some soldiers because I'm down to 6. That's not good at all. And I have no choice here what squad to take. That's the only 4 non-wounded soldiers I have. So this will be fun. 2 assault, heavy and rookie. Yeah, that's the strangest setup ever. Just changing this dude's color. Alright. Hopefully I can get this dude promoted to sniper or something like that. Oh, and yeah, obviously they need carapace armor. I almost forgot about that.
This new body armor.
Yeah, this will help. At least they won't die in one hit now, hopefully. Well, they still can if they get critted by the outsider dudes, the energy ones. I got crit for 9 damage in the last part, if I remember right. That was just nasty. And one more. There we go. Yeah, this will definitely help. So, let's do it.
Strike one.
After this mission is done, I need to hire some new soldiers. I should have some new junk to sell.
The aliens went down in a sparsely populated area.
So I won't have to sell all my corpses to do that.
Come in, HQ. Big Sky has reached the outer marker. Approaching the crash site now.
I really do need to do this mission without any losses, though. I really can't lose any more soldiers at this point. I do have one heavy, so I'm going to save the rocket for the outsider. And I'm just going to blast his face off with the rocket. There should be only one inside the actual UFO, so it's kind of predictable.
Positive enemy contacts.
Not a great start. My position isn't the best ever. I think I'm flanked from this side a bit. Yeah, I might as well just back up out of their range. I could hide here behind full cover, but there might be some more aliens on this side. But yeah, I'm going to hide here. This should be safe. They can still shoot at this dude. But he has 10 HP, so unless I get crit twice, I won't die, I think. I hope. Nice. I need to get laser weapons as fast as possible. It's kind of annoying how I need to hit them twice or even 3 times in some cases. Yeah, great, he's shooting me. Alright, let's do this. I think I'll just use run and gun. Actually, no, not yet. I'm going to try finishing him off with the rookie, so that he can get some more experience. I want to get him promoted in this mission. Only 25%, but it's not going to get better, so might as well try. Yeah, I missed. There was one more alien there, I think. So I'm going to stay here. This still isn't a very safe spot. Oh yeah, I should have used this first because of the holo targeting. I'm going to use run and gun. I want to kill this dude on this turn. I could run here. I would be behind full cover then. Yeah, I'm doing that. ...80%, that's pretty good. And down you go. Taken care of indeed. But yeah, the carapace armor is going to make a huge difference in survivability. If my sniper in the previous part had carapace armor, then she wouldn't have died, even with the crit. Obviously that wasn't possible since I didn't have it researched yet, but I'm just saying. Right, let's shoot with the rookie. I want to get more experience for him. Won't have a high chance from here, but might as well try. Oh, I can't see him from here at all. Probably because this is lower ground. So this is blocking line of sight. Yeah, I'm going to shoot him with the pistol. Yeah, I didn't expect that to hit, but still better chance than with a shotgun at this range. Yeah, I should have done this first as well. I keep forgetting about that ability. It's nice because it works even if I miss. So I quite like that. Yeah, this time I'm going to start with the heavy. No, I can't because he's out of ammo, great. I guess I could run up and blow his face off with a shotgun. Actually no, I can't. I'd have to stand around without cover. I'm definitely not doing that.
Missed the target.
Come on, dude, hit. Nice.
Hostiles pacified.
And he got a promotion. Awesome. I hope he'll get sniper or something. I could really use a sniper right now. So like I said, I'm saving the rocket for the outsider. There's the UFO. I guess I'm going to switch to the pistol when I'm doing Overwatch with this dude. The shotgun has awful accuracy. Then it's kind of unlikely the aliens will just run up straight to my face. That wouldn't happen anyway, since they reaction shot as soon as they see them. So it seems kind of pointless to use shotgun with Overwatch, unless you're expecting the aliens to pop up in close range. Oh great! I'm not using rocket for that though.
No way that just happened.
Yeah, way, that just happened. Yeah, this is going to be fun. At least the shotgun should be a bit more useful. I could move up here and shoot them from fairly close range. I could also move here, but then this sectoid could flank me most likely. Also, this time I'm not going to make the same mistake and start with the heavy. But I'm moving him behind this tree. He should see at least one floater from here. Yeah, he can. Nice. Alright, that's one down. I can just shoot from here, I guess. 65% is pretty good. Not good enough. Okay, I'm going to run up here. I could run behind this wall, which is full cover, but like I said, this sectoid could flank me then. So that's not really a good idea. And I should have a pretty good chance to hit from here. Yeah, 90%. And he's down. Awesome. And I still have one more shot. I could use run and gun and shoot from here. Yeah, I'm going to do that. This should be good. Only 33. Oh, I had pistol on, damn it. I screwed that one up. Completely. I almost never use pistols, so I forget about switching. Great, he actually hit me. Alright, well, let's see. I won't hit him with the shotgun. I know as much. And I'm not going to use a rocket, because I still need it. There isn't really any other good spot around here. I could dash here and hide behind this tree, but if there are aliens here, then I'm going to be kind of screwed. But I think I'm going to risk it anyway. This dude does have 10 HP. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, I'm good. I'm going to back up this dude. I don't want him to die. I guess I can shoot with a pistol from here, but yeah, well, 43% isn't that bad. And I actually hit. Only one damage, but that does mean the rookie could kill him on his turn now, if he hits. Oh, there's another one. And he's on Overwatch. So I probably want to shoot from here. Only 26. Yeah, I'm going to shoot this dude on Overwatch. Nice. Damn it. Oh, that wasn't a good choice. I didn't notice my cover is down. Yeah, that's not good at all. I do have run and gun though, I can just run up here and blow his face off. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I can't risk him shooting my dude without cover. This should do the trick. Should have 100% from here with the shotgun, yep. You're going down. Oh, I thought for a second I still have a pistol on. So this is going well so far. I didn't bring a medkit with me though, that's not a good choice. I didn't actually notice that when I was starting the mission. so I need to be careful.
Ready to engage.
Okay, I'm going to keep the heavy outside and go inside to check what's in there. There might be an outsider inside, although I'm not quite sure about that. Outsider, I mean.
It's killing time.
And there are still aliens outside, most likely.
Shh, you hear that?
Yeah, I need to switch back to the shotgun before I forget. Oh, hi. I got visitors.
Cover my flank! They're backing up! Advance!
Okay, let's see how best to deal with this dude. I could run here and just shoot him from here. I kind of need to hit them though. Oh, no targets available. But that means he won't have line of sight to me either. So I'm going to switch to Overwatch. No run and gun here. So Overwatch on this dude as well, I suppose. I could shoot from here. Not good. I can't really move this dude because there's no cover. I can move him here, I guess. This is actually a pretty good spot. Come on, hit. Nice. This dude got quite a few kills in this mission. Alright, let's go in, but carefully.
The alien flight computer could prove to be extremely useful in our own research. Please take great care in returning it to the base.
Yeah, yeah. I'll try not to blow it up with the rocket. I promise. Actually, I don't promise. If there's outsider inside, then I'm going to blow it up. Alright, let's go in. Nothing so far. I have to dash here, I really have no other choice. Yeah, I need to move this dude to a slightly safer spot. This should be good. Nothing here. Interesting. Are they outside then? Yeah, I guess there are more aliens outside, yeah, on this side. That's where I'm going then. But I'm not going to rush it. Thank you. And now I can open it on the next turn.
What was that?
Yeah, he's definitely behind here. I'm probably going to see him now. There we go. Yeah, that's the outsider, dude. I need to kill him on this turn.
Watch the flanks.
Yeah, how am I going to do that, though? I need to back up. I'm not going to kill him on this turn. But I can stay behind full cover. And with everyone on Overwatch. Yeah, I need to move this dude way back. I should have used Run and Gun there, probably. Well, everyone except one dude is on Overwatch, and the alien has to move to be able to hit me at all. See, he can't see me right now. So he has to move. Come on. Is he moving away or what? Yeah, I'm going to stay here for one more turn. Come on. Show your face. Yeah, he's quite obviously moving. At least it seems so. I guess I need to move myself. I need to kill him before he gets a chance to fire at me. Because if he crits me, he can still kill me in one shot. Even in Carapace armor. He could kill this dude, for example, since he can crit for 9 damage. He could kill this dude as well. I, on the other hand, can't kill him in one hit. Well, I'm not sure if he's still around the corner. And I'm a bit too paranoid to move in there. Come on, show your face. He's moving around the UFO or something. He might be trying to flank me from the other side. Yeah, I'm not quite sure what to do now. Well, I guess I'm going to move in. Yeah, he's not here. I think he's going around then. Which means I need to set up like this. And I guess I'm going to open this force field. Or he's just confused, wandering around. Oh, there he is! That was... no comment. Yeah, I'm not prepared for him coming from this side. I can't blast him with a rocket because he's too close. I can throw a grenade, or I can shoot from here. Okay, I'm going to throw a grenade to hit him like this without hitting my own heavy. And then I'm going to just run in and blow off his face. Okay, that's one. And now I should be able to blow his face off. Oh, I can't move with this dude or what? There we go. 91. I should just move right next to him. Although I'm not sure if he's the last alien on the map now. Might be safer to just move behind cover. Or try shooting with someone else first. I'll try shooting with Bilbo. You got your chance, Buggins, to score another kill. Nice.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. And it's done. So let's see what class I'm going to get on that rookie. Hopefully a sniper.
Looks like they're really taking care of business down there.
Yes, nice, awesome. This is exactly what I needed. And I got a corporal promotion, sergeant promotion actually. Oh yeah, that's what unlocks the officer training school. Oh, and yeah, he can get a nickname now. Let's see here. Yeah, I'm getting suppression. Yeah, I'm definitely getting suppression. If only for the aim penalty on my target. Alright. I should be able to do one more mission in this video, so I'm not editing the names right now because I don't have the list handy. And I can't exactly alt about while recording. So I'm just going to edit them at the start of the next part. Alright, but the main priority right now is to build the officer training school. How much is that going to cost me? 125. Let's have a look. I could sell some corpses. I don't really need corpses all that much. They are mostly used for one of the boosts for the interceptors. I forgot which one. But I'm going to get a lot more sectoid corpses. So this is enough. And now I can start building the officer training school. I think I'm going to build it here because these are nice linking spots. And I'm going to have a steam generator here. Whatever it was called. Thermal generator. It's a shame this map only has one steam. That's kind of going to suck. I guess I'm going to need Ellerium power generator later on in the game. But for now, officer training school. And I'm going to need to upgrade my squad size as soon as I can. Alright, satellite uplink done. This should mean I can launch 3 more satellites. Indeed I can. I'm finishing satellites in 6 days, but one of them is going to go for the request from France. Just because I can get 200 credits for the satellite, which costs... how much is one satellite? Yeah, 72. So that's a nice profit. How is the panic looking like? Yeah, not very good. A bit nasty, in fact. I'm probably going to launch one satellite on India. Not sure about the other one. We'll see. Let's continue for now. You want scopes? Yeah, I guess I can deliver that. Oh, I need more credits then. Yeah, I don't want to sell all of the sectoid corpses. But I don't want to sell alien alloys or weapon fragments either. These are way more important than corpses. Alright, nice. Oh yeah, this is the terror mission. Oh great, this is going to be fun. This one will have chrysalids. And I can't afford to fail it. Oh yes, this is going to be fun. Well, at least I have a sniper now. That's definitely going to help quite a bit. Alright, but let's not screw up the med deep packs this time. Yeah, I can't take support because she's still wounded. That kind of sucks. I guess I'm going to give the med packs to my assault dudes? I think so. I'm going to give scope to the sniper. Oh, I can't because I don't have scopes, I have to make one. Yeah, because I fulfilled the request. Okay, let's make one. Oh, I do have one scope. I think it's on one of the wounded soldiers or what?
Commander,
where is it?
Number of casualties and haven't found suitable replacements yet.
We need to I don't think they should have any gear on them. Am I being blind or what? Let's check this again. Oh yeah, I have scope right here. I'm just blind. Right. Never mind that then. I'm kind of tempted to change his weapon, but... yeah, I don't think it makes all that much difference except at extreme range. So in fact... yeah, I'm keeping the shotguns. Alright, these dudes are getting the med packs. Medikits, whatever. And the sniper is getting the scope. Maybe I should get some nano vests or whatever they are called. I think that might not be such a bad idea considering there are chrysalids in this mission, so it might get quite nasty. Yeah, I'm going to make a few of those. Nanofiber vest, that's it. They are quite cheap. I can get at least one for my heavy. The grenade is nice, but I have a rocket for extreme situations. Yeah, I'm going to give this to my heavy. Alright, now I'm ready. Yeah, this looks good now. I have two medikits, sniper, and heavy with nanofiber vest. This looks solid, let's go. I can't afford to fail this mission. Well, I can't afford to fail any terror missions because that affects the entire continent, if I'm not mistaken, not just the country it's in.
The threat there seems to be the most pressing.
But yeah, the chrysalids are going to be fun on this one. I definitely can't rush this one. I know I'm supposed to save civilians, but that's just not worth rushing for. I can save a few right at the start of the zone, it seems. Yeah, I can save someone turn one.
You're safe now. Go, go, go!
And I don't think I can fail the mission unless I lose all 18, and considering I already saved some, I should be safe.
I got you. You're safe.
I do think the panic on the continent depends on the success level you have in the terror mission. Even if you succeed the terror mission, but with a bad score, you still get some panic increase. I'm not 100% sure about that. I think that's how it works. But like I said, I can't really afford losing any of these soldiers, so I really can't rush. And if I dash forward and see chrysalids, for example, then I'm going to have a really bad time. So I seriously need to be careful on this one. So you might disagree with not rushing a terror mission, but I'm not going to change my mind. Oh yeah, I need to save this one as well. That's three saved already. I think I need to save four. To not get terrible score at civilians. I'm not 100% sure about that. But I think it's 4, not to get a terrible score. And half of them, or 8 of them to get good, I would need to check that. Doesn't matter. There are some inside here. So let's go in that general direction. I can save this dude. But I'm going to use run and gun for that. This isn't the safest spot ever.
Going in for the kill.
But let's do it anyway.
You're good to go. Now move.
Okay, that's 4 saved. I don't think I can get a terrible score at this anymore, even if I lose all the rest. Ah, I switched to pistol and the hotkey on Overwatch changed from 3 to 2. So I pressed 3 and did hunker down instead of Overwatch with the pistol. But yeah, this is the main threat right now, the chrysalids. It's a good thing I had most of them on Overwatch. They missed though, so that's not very helpful. Alright, this is going to be exciting. Let's start with the sniper. I can headshot one of them. Please hit. Nice. I was hoping for a crit, but I guess you can't have everything. It's a shame I don't have runnet gun now, that would be useful. I need to get out of here. And fast. Okay, I'm going to move him back here, then shoot, then move the other one, shoot. And then use the rocket. I think that's going to be the best right now. If I miss with 80% chance to hit, that's just purely bad luck and nothing else. Maybe I could save my rocket right now actually. But yeah, I'm close enough for them to be able to attack me, I'm pretty sure about that. Okay, so what I'm going to do is move this dude back. Now I'm going to use a rocket, which should kill two of them. Actually, not necessarily. Yeah, it actually won't kill both of them. That's kind of annoying. I could only kill one. Yeah, if I shoot like this, then I won't hit the one in the back. If I shoot like this, I won't hit the one on the right side. Let's shoot this dude, but not with a pistol, with a shotgun. 76%. Well, I don't really have any other choice. I hope I hit. There we go. And now... this dude can't actually see this chrysalid, and if he wants to attack me in melee, which he does, then he's going to have to move towards me. So I think it's best to put this guy on Overwatch and save my rocket for now, since the chrysalid is definitely going to move towards me. So yeah, I'm going to put this dude on Overwatch and hope he hits. Come on, hit. Did he hit? No, he missed. Damn it. But he's moving the other way. Oh, he wants to kill the civilian and turn him into a zombie. Yeah. I lost that civilian, unfortunately. Well, let's move in then. Come on, hit! Nice! Did that civilian turn into a zombie or not? I can't see. Oh, there are two more outside, I need to save them fast. But I'm not going to rush towards them. This is about as far as I'm willing to rush. I still don't like it. It's dangerous if there are any aliens in here. Yeah, no, I'm not doing it without having granite gun. If I lose these two civilians, well, that happens. For now I'm glad I dealt with these chrysalids without losing anyone and without taking any damage. Everyone is at full HP still, So that's actually kind of successful so far. Alright, let's see. Now I can use Run-It Gun. Okay, I can use Run-It Gun and go here. Here or here.
Run them down.
Yeah, here is better because there could be some aliens outside here. They probably would have killed the civilians by now, in that case. But yeah, this is just a safer spot overall.
Contact.
There we go, yeah. This is exactly what I kind of feared. But now I can actually shoot one of them, but not very effectively. I think it's better to switch this dude to Overwatch, because only one floater can see me. He could shoot me without moving, but unless he crits really badly, he won't kill this dude in one hit. And this is actually full cover? Oh yeah, because it's a wall. Okay, so I can move other one here, put him on Overwatch as well. Again, only one alien can see me. And there's one more up there, upstairs. If he wants to shoot me, he will have to move. And then I can do a reaction shot. And this dude can go here, I suppose. And I think I'm going to move the sniper as well. And put him on Overwatch with the pistol. Yeah, I think this is going to be the safest setup. Oh, he went on Overwatch himself. Interesting move. Oh, more floaters from the right. Damn it.
I'll get him next time.
Yeah, I'm sure you will.
Time to kick this sucker off.
Come on. Alright, let's see what to do now. Good question. My sniper should be able to kill someone by now. 65%? Well, that's about as good as it gets, really. What I can do is start with my heavy. To use holo targeting on one of these. So that's what I'm going to do. The dude up here. Yeah, I missed, but now I should get an aim bonus with my sniper. Yeah, 75% now. So I'm going to take that shot. Just don't miss, dude. Come on. Nice. Good shot. Alright. And I'm going to withdraw this dude because I have floaters coming in from the right. And they could easily flank me in this position. So I'm going to move back here. I know he was on Overwatch, but I really needed to move. He missed anyway. Only 13%. I'm just going to set him on Overwatch. He can take a reaction shot at these floaters coming in from the right then. They might choose to kill the civilians instead, but there's not much I can do about that, really. I could switch to pistol and take a shot with better accuracy, but that's not going to kill him. That's going to do one or two damage at best. Yeah, I'm going to set him on Overwatch with a shotgun. And this dude? I could move him here. And then take a shot. At the ones on the right, maybe. 58%. Yeah, I'll try it. This dude might try to kill the civilians, so if I hit, that would be nice. Okay. That might have saved the civilian just now. Going well so far. Okay. Let's have a look around. Yeah, I need to reload my shotgun. This dude can't see anything. Well, it's just this floater back here left now. Okay, I'm going to run here, shoot at him, which should activate holo targeting. have to say, I actually like holo-targeting ability quite a lot now. The aim bonus is nice, and it activates even if I miss, which is even nicer. I could just run up here or so. Nice. Okay, let's save some of these civilians now. But without rushing. I need to reload my shotgun. Only 4 civilians died, so that's not too bad. Did he hit? I didn't see. I don't think so. He's upstairs or something. I can't actually see him right now. That's a bit annoying. I guess I should run upstairs, but that doesn't look very safe. I do have run and gun, so I suppose I could use that and run here. Yeah, let's do that. I don't like this, but... yeah, I can see something now. Now I can't. But, well, he has reaction shot up. Yeah, I can save this dude. But that will involve sprinting. Yeah, this dude needs to reload. Let's rock. Okay, I'm not quite sure where exactly that floater is, but he's somewhere in this direction. So I'm going to set up here. I got 2 dudes on Overwatch, so if he shows his face, I can shoot him. There he is. Yeah, he's downstairs, not upstairs. Shot failed to connect. Or he could have just moved down. Out of rounds. Well, doesn't matter, I know where he is now. Yeah, he's shooting a civilian, damn it. Well, not much I could have done about that. But now I need to kill him. Ah, I'm out of ammo, again. I could use a rocket, but I don't want to kill civilians with it. I could also use run and gun now and shoot him from here. Or just from here. It should be okay if there are no more aliens in that room. It's a bit risky, but I can guarantee killing him this way. Bye!
Excellent work.
Oh, that was the last
one. Objectives complete.
Not bad. I guess I was probably 1 or 2 civilians short from excellent. I'm not sure if you need to save all 18 for excellent or not. But well, this was a successful mission nevertheless. So let's have a look. What can I do before I finish this part?
If all our missions go
nice, some promotions.
The aliens don't stand a chance.
Another sergeant? Yeah, lightning reflexes for sure. Bilbo Baggins is doing quite well. Yeah, squad side, there's no real question about that. And tactical sense. Alright. So, that was quite a successful mission. I'm going to hire some new soldiers. 2 should be enough for now. And I'm going to finish this part here and continue in next one. So I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you next time.